Earlier, it got compared to For Never World. I don't think he has something like this. What's going on, guys? Welcome to another edition of Star Wars Rebels, the Vision of Hope. And in this episode, we're going to talk, you know, spoilers. This is a spoiler episode, so I'm assuming you saw the episode. These are just my thoughts. Now, when I first saw the opening of Ezra having a vision, I really did like, however, them having him trained to deflect the lasers, but not deflect the lasers anywhere, but have a specific target. That's some smart ass writing right there. That's some writing where, hey, look at this, he's a Jedi, and we haven't seen that before. We've seen Luke Skywalker deflect, you know, lasers from the movies, being blinded. Okay, that's good and dandy, but you know, these Jedi still have to be trained to deflect lasers and hit their target too. That's, you see that common. So that was a great way to start off the episode, to show something that we haven't really seen before. But I mean, Sabine Jib and Chopper, it seems like they're a little bit way too, you know, enjoying themselves and shooting at Ezra. Gotta say though, right off the bat, I know it's too early in the review, but Chopper versus R2-D2. Want to see it happen. Can we make that happen? Make it a death battle. Don't care. But yeah, we see Ezra, you know, he has a vision. And then, you know, that vision made me think about episode 3 with Anakin. You know, I won't let you die. Or whatever. You can't do the Christian Hayden scenario. How's it go? He goes, I won't let you die, Padme. Something like that. It's stale. His performance is freaking stale, all right? So basically, we see Ezra having a vision about the senator who is basically a senator who's we've seen in the course of the season, basically. I forgot his name, though. You know, the beacon of hope, really transporting messages and stuff, saying, hey, the rebels are bad. You know, I'm here to protect your freedom. And he's doing an inside message where all his messages usually coordinate to a meeting place. Right off the bat, I was like, this is a trap. This has to be a trap. And you know, it ended up being a freaking trap. I gotta say though, this episode, what I really liked about this episode was the dialogue, the snarky comedic exchanges from the dialogue. I mean, especially with the sewage, you know, Ezra, you know, you get used to the smell, and Jib's like, you never get used to the smell. And then, of course, Sabine's saying, it smells like you. And he goes, well, how do you know how I smell? So I did like, you know, all the dialogue that was used in here. I thought it was a pretty good episode overall. I didn't think it wasn't too high intense. I mean, we all knew that guy was, I mean, you can see it a mile away that guy, it was a trap, and that guy was gonna, you know, working for the rebel all this time. You knew from the beginning of the episode with Kanan really foreshadowing, hey, your vision, you have to see clearly. Just because it's a vision doesn't automatically mean that this is going to go down. It goes down, but it goes down in a different way. We've seen that already with Anakin in episode 3. But overall, you know, I really enjoyed this episode. I thought beautiful, beautiful cinematography in some of these scenes, especially them going through the tunnel. I mean, just the cinematography alone in this episode, I think, was top notch. There was like dark kind of shadows like going on. I mean, things you saw in Star Wars, really, in the prequels. The good thing about those prequels is they some of those shots that they had in those prequel movies was the cinematography, was the shading, was Tatooine, you know, was the dark side really cloud like the shadows they use in those movies. And I thought they did this in this episode really well done. Also the music. There were some pieces of music I haven't heard before, which I thought was phenomenal, and I thought really just made the episode even better. So, I mean, Ezra, he's learned that, hey, now he's learning basically how to deflect lasers, or the laser guns. He's learning how to, the visions that are not all cracked out, what there used to be. He's learning to pretty much not trust too much of a public figure, because you never know. You know, this guy was a public figure trying to, you know, trying to basically lure out the rebels, and they thought he was a good guy, but he was not. And then I think it was hinted that maybe Ezra's parents are dead. Not sure about that. I don't think they're dead, honestly. Or I think at least one parent's alive. So we'll see in the future episodes. And it was great to see Hera and Ezra, you know, connect towards the very end of this as well. That, you know, Hera was along with him, that she wanted to believe in this guy, but he ended up turning into a baddie. What I really liked, though, was Chopper. Chopper took out that bot like nothing. What a G. Chopper's starting to be one of my favorites as well. If it's not R2-D2, bring in Chopper. Chopper's a cool character. Hopefully, J.J. Abrams, you know, I know he wants comedic relief. I know R2-D2 and C-3PO are going to be in the film, but I'm pretty sure he wants to introduce another type droid that has the same attitude as R2-D2. Chopper, I think, has a worse attitude than R2-D2. I believe this was Chopper episode for some reason. And it was great to see that cadet, you know, that Ezra befriended in the when they're doing the cadets training when he was undercover. It was great to see that he's still working, you know, undercover. He's feeding Ezra all this information that the Empire is supplying. He's going to, of course, be going transferring somewhere else, so you won't see him as much. I think he's working under the Inquisitor. So my feeling is that it's kind of hard. Maybe he's betraying Ezra in some way. I mean, in this episode, I think it kind of hints at it. But we'll see. I mean, it was great to see his character as well. I think his name was Trev. It might have been Trev. For some reason, I want to say Trev. So, great episode. Good episode. I mean, not the best of the episode, but it was really, you know, it was really well done. There were some good things to like in this episode. So, overall, definitely was happy for this episode. Definitely liked some of the newer stuff that we saw with that Jedi training. Just a little bit of it. And the music. The music was really, really good. And the cinematography was really, really good. So, can't wait till next episode. And thank you guys for listening. If you liked this video, please push the like button. And please subscribe for more Star Wars. I used to have a Mace Windu one. Totally broke it. See you guys.